Hi, I'm Maria Wells, broker owner of Lifestyle Realty Group on the Treasure Coast of Florida and also with an office in Lehigh Valley, Pennsylvania. Practicing real estate during COVID has been night and day between Florida and Pennsylvania. Can you imagine when the pandemic hit in Pennsylvania, there were no showings, no appraisals, no new closings after the lockdown date, no inspectors were allowed in the home, no repairs could be made, no photography. You couldn't even put a sign out on a piece of property that was for sale. It's true. In the state of Pennsylvania, none of this could proceed. It really changed the course of realtors, brokers, buyers, and sellers and how you do business. Many who were contemplating getting into real estate and study for their license, I've now stepped back and said, I've got to see what's going to happen in the state of Pennsylvania. The local realtor associations were doing food drives, not for the community, but for realtors. Can you imagine? Because they weren't able to make any money. It actually was so heartbreaking. As realtors here in Florida, if you take these conditions and you look at your list of clients, I'm sure you can imagine how impacted you would be in your own real estate practice. For boundless reasons, we are so fortunate to live in this great state of Florida. The weather, low taxes, our real estate is booming. We have a governor who is pro-business, and our RPAC dollars have been spent building those relationships and keeping real estate listed as an essential business. In past years, through RPAC and Florida Realtors, there have been bills passed to protect private property rights. And now, more than ever, we can appreciate keeping our profession essential. It's at the top of our accomplishments. As 2017 president of Florida Realtors, I know how important it is for RPAC and for the relationships that Florida Realtors builds with our local officials. I encourage you to please give to RPAC so that we can make sure that our profession, for not only our buyers and sellers and our community, but also for ourselves, remain essential and that we can do all that we need to do to protect private property rights.